Hello everyone, this is Priyanka. Welcome to my channel Priyanka's IT School. Today I am sharing 10 tutorial on software testing. Topic is software testing life cycle. In previous tutorial, we have discussed testing fundamentals, then SDLC, SDLC models, right? So what is software development life cycle? SDLC. So SDLC defines the process of application development with phases, and testing phase of SDLC is further expanded in software testing life cycle, and that is nothing but SDLC. So guys, testing is not only limited just to find bugs, but has a wider scope and required right from the beginning of the project. That is right from the requirement phase of SDLC. Since testing is also standardized, just like development of software has a life cycle, testing too has a life cycle, and which we can refer as STLC, software testing life cycle. Now question is, what is STLC? So guys, STLC defines series of activities performed by testing team which should be carried out systematically to ensure quality of developed software. So STLC defines group of testing related activities which should carried out throughout the life cycle. So let's understand generic software testing life cycle along with its phases. STLC have total 6 different phases, okay, which we need to understand in detail. So let's understand first phase of STLC, that is requirement or test analysis phase. What is this phase? See, once requirement get gathered by BA, that is business analyst, from the client, then QA team is responsible to understand and analyze those requirement. So here QA team will interact with various stakeholder, let's say client, business analyst, technical lead, system analyst, to understand requirement in detail. Okay, so QA team is not only analyze all the client requirement, but entire team is responsible to understand all the design document, all the code document too, just to understand entire flow of software application. So here QA team identify testable requirements and gather application knowledge and detail about the priorities and focus areas of software application. So here, what is the tester role? Tester understand client requirement and prepare some testable set of requirement, gather some testable set of requirement. So guys, what is the concept of test analysis? Test analysis is nothing but here we need to analyze all the test bases. So now I have referred here term, that is, let's say test bases. What is mean by test bases? Test bases are nothing but all the document which tester can refer during testing. So nothing but all the requirement document, design document, code document, just to understand entire application flow, entire application architecture, right? Tester is responsible to understand very first all the client requirement, and then only we can proceed with the further phases. So very first we have requirement or test analysis phase. Here tester analyze all the client requirement and prepare testable set of requirement or testable feature for that software application. Now second phase we have, that is test planning. What is this test planning? See, test planning is most important phase of software testing life cycle, where roadmap for all testing activities get defined by test manager. So roadmap, here I have used a term, that is roadmap. So whenever we need to continue with testing activity, at that time we should know all the detail about that entire testing process, right? Like example, when to start testing, when to stop testing, what kind of environment we required while doing testing, right? What we need to perform, which approach we need to continue, right? Whether we need to perform black box testing, whether we need to perform white box testing, all these details are important. And that's the reason test planning is nothing but which describe roadmap about testing activities. So here test manager is responsible to prepare test plan for testing activities. So test plan is a high level plan document which defines scope, objective, risk, overall approach of testing, scheduling of test activities, assigning resource for activities, budget budgeting for test activities and determine level of detail and structure for test document. So everything is there in a test plan document. So once test planning is completed by test manager and test plan document is ready, then QA team need to understand test plan document for further testing activities. So here what we can say, requirement document, that is SRS document, and test plan document, these two documents are considered high level document through which or on the basis of which we can continue further testing process. Again guys, test planning, we can say at this level or at this particular phase, this test plan document may be revised or update based on the feedback from monitoring and control activities. So what is a third phase in testing life cycle which we have, that is test designing. So once we have plan ready with us, once we analyze all the client requirement, we can start with a third phase activity, that is nothing but test designing activity. What is test designing? So in test designing, tester is responsible to prepare, to perform variety of tasks, not only test case writing, but there are variety of tasks we need to continue. See, very first let's understand what tester can perform here. Very first, based on the documentation, okay, we are on, we are on test design. Yeah. So what happened here in test designing, this phase is described how to perform testing activities. So how to test, right? So once requirement related document, design document, code document get analyzed by tester, then tester is responsible to prepare very first test scenario. So very first here we need to prepare some test scenario. Now question is, what is this test scenario, right? So guys, test scenario is nothing but high level testable feature of application. So very first, once you understand all the documentation, what is your role as a tester? You need to identify some high level feature, high level testable feature of the application. And all those set of testable feature are nothing but we are doing scenario writing activity. Okay. So test scenario preparation is nothing but we need to prepare some kind of scenarios, and those scenarios are nothing but high level testable feature of software application. Once scenario is completed, then tester can start test case writing activity. So test case preparation done by tester, right? So once scenario is ready, then and then only we can start, we can simply detail out all those scenario in a test case template, and that is nothing but tester is responsible to prepare test cases. So here not only preparation, but we need to understand, we need to focus on prioritization task too. Okay, so test case prioritization and test case preparation done by tester. Now third phase is here, that is test data preparation process. Okay, test data preparation process. What is this? See, what is meant by test data? Data which we can refer during testing, that is nothing but, or which we required during testing or to conduct testing, and that is nothing but test data. But here how we can prepare a data, right? So guys, data can be of two type, okay, synthetic data or real data. What is mean by real data? Whenever we are testing any application, at that time client will provide some kind of data to you, okay? So whenever, or let's say data provided by the client, it is referred as a real data, and based on that data only we need to continue further testing process. What is mean by synthetic data? Synthetic data is something, which we need to analyze, which we need to understand from the requirement. Okay. So whenever there is a requirement, based on that requirement, we need to collect some data, and that is nothing but test data preparation task. Once this task is completed, so once scenario are ready, once test cases are ready, once test data is also prepared, then we need to identify as a tester, tester is responsible to perform or prepare RTM. Okay, what is this RTM? RTM stands for requirement traceability matrix. Okay, this is just mapping between requirement and test cases and vice versa. So RTM is prepared just to ensure coverage of entire requirement, that is how much we have covered in our test case writing act. Okay, so here RTM need to prepare by QA team. And again, we are responsible. I mean, tester is responsible to identify environment. Okay, so we need to identify here environment. So what is environment here, guys? Yes, can you tell me what is meant by environment? So environment, it is all about testable environment. Okay, so tester is responsible to identify environment. That is nothing but again infrastructure. Then we need to identify some kind of tool to be used while testing. Okay, so as a tester is responsible to work in this way in test designing phase. Okay, so test scenario preparation, test case preparation, test data preparation, RTM preparation and identifying testing environment. We need to continue in this test designing phase. Once test designing is completed, so here tester is responsible to perform such a kind of activities: scenario writing, test case writing, test data, RTM and environment identification. Once this process is completed, then and then only we can proceed with our next phase, that is test implementation. So now, during test implementation, test web, that is testing related document, is created and completed for test execution phase, that is test implementation is used. Okay, why this phase is required? Because we need to perform here, we need to verify here readiness of testing environment. So before proceed with test execution phase, that environment should be ready. Right. So in this phase, QA team is responsible to verify readiness of testing environment. So again, here we are responsible to, create test suite. So now I have used here two terms. Let's say what is meant by testware. Okay, so testware is nothing but all testing related documentation. So all the documentation, scenario documentation, test case documentation, data documentation, RTM documentation, defect documentation, anything we can consider as a testing related document is referred as testware. And second is nothing but test suite. What is meant by test suite? Test suite is nothing but collection of test cases. Okay, so in test implementation, QA team is responsible to verify readiness of testing environment or readiness of entire environment and creation of test suite. So test suite is a collection of test cases and prioritize test suite, sequencing test suite for execution. So entire schedule get prepared in this test implementation phase. And again, tester is also responsible to prepare test script in this phase. What is meant by test script here? So guys, test script is nothing but step-by-step procedure or action need to perform on that test, okay, which we can prepare in a particular coding language or in a particular scripting language. So whenever we need to continue a testing activity for automation testing, then simply all the automation required test script or automation testing test script get prepared in this test implementation phase. Okay, so we can simply refer that what is this test implementation. So test implementation, here tester prepare test script and verify readiness of testing environment for execution process. Once environment is ready, one test cases is ready, one entire infrastructure, required tool, required software is ready, then and then only we can go for the next phase, that is test execution and bug reporting. Now in this phase, actual execution is take place. QA team execute all scheduled test cases, that is test suite, on software application and execution. As an execution outcome, QA team log the bug in bug report. Okay, so here bug is nothing but defect, right? So what is execution task? During execution, test cases get executed with software and all the defect, all the bug get recorded by team in defect report or in a specific tool, whatever it is mentioned by the organization. So this execution process carried out manually or with the help of automation tool depend on organization requirement. So in this phase, major tasks are, let's say, perform execution of test cases, compare actual result with expected result and report defect based on the failure observed. Whenever we found a defect, then tester responsibility is log those defect, right? So whenever we log the defect in defect report, then what is the next task here? Once we completed the login activity, after that That is, after bug reporting, where we need to report a bug? We need to report a bug at development site. So once we report a bug at development site, here entire, after this phase, entire development, entire bug life cycle carried out. Okay, so bug life cycle, defect, that is nothing but defect life cycle, where again there are variety of phases available and through which, you know, every defect need to be focused in that defect life cycle. Okay, so test execution and bug reporting, this is our main task. Okay, here we can execute all the test cases, we can apply all the test cases on software, and we can execute those test cases, we can identify actual result and expected result difference, and whenever we found difference, those difference we can report in terms of bug in a defect defect tracking sheet, in a defect reporting sheet. Okay, at development site we can simply pass that report, right, for the further defect life cycle process. So once it is completed, then and then only, so after all the defect, whenever all the defect get fixed by development side, so entire development life cycle whenever complete, or entire defect life cycle whenever complete, then we can go for the last phase, that is test completion or test closure phase. What is this? See, test closure activities are mostly done where let's say when software is released. Okay, so where all the data testware get collect from completed test activities for future reference. So this phase is all about process improvement tasks. So as per agile development, retrospective meeting is performed at the end of every sprint, and that is nothing but test closure activity for agile process. Okay, so what are the main tasks? I mean, let's understand some major activities performed during test completion and closure. So checking all defect report are closed, right? Whatever we report in this phase, we need to verify here in test completion whether all defect get closed successfully or not, right? So creation of test summary report, finalizing, archiving test environment, test data, testware for future reference, right? Handover documentation or testware to the maintenance team or project team or maybe to client. So based on collected information, improve test process maturity. And in this way, guys, we have total 6 phases in software testing life cycle. So again, while executing the STLC, one more phase is important and which should execute throughout the life cycle. That is nothing, that is we can say from this requirement analysis phase till this test closure phase. Okay, so that phase is nothing but test monitoring and control phase. See, during software we can say a life cycle, or during the life cycle, every phase need to be monitored, right? So whenever we are working in testing life cycle, this every phase need to be monitored. Okay, and that's the reason, what is this entire, I mean the main purpose of test monitoring is to gather information and provide feedback and visibility about testing activities, right? So information to be monitored may be collected manually or automatically and should be used, you know, to assess test progress. So monitoring is important, and test control, it is all about, you know, activities, I mean test control activities involve taking necessary action to meet objective of test plan. So as per a test plan, whenever we need to monitor entire progress, that is nothing but test monitoring. And as for the test plan, whenever we require to take some necessary action, that is nothing but test control. So test control is a backup plan if plan fails, right? So QA team is responsible to create all the testware, that is testing document, during each phase of testing life cycle. So let's understand what kind of documentation are required to create. Okay, so very first, from let's say from this phase, requirement analysis or test analysis phase, QA team identify all the set of testable requirement or features. At the time of test planning phase, test manager prepare test plan document. So test planning is considered as a testware, or we can say outcome from this test planning phase. During test designing, QA team prepared scenario document, test case document, test data document, RTM document, that is requirement traceability matrix document. Again, test implementation during this phase, readiness of environment get checked and all the automated script get prepared by QA team. Then at the time of execution and bug reporting, test execution and bug reporting phase, QA team, they prepare some kind of execution report, defect report, report, okay, get prepared by the QA team. So during monitoring and test control, test progress report, summary report prepared by test manager. And similarly, at the time of test closure, here we need to tester prepare entire success, entire project report, okay, along with its all detail, all the related documentation. So that is all about software testing life cycle. Now, every organization have different phases in STLC. So here we discuss generic phases. Okay. So that's all for this video. Please do subscribe, like my videos, and thanks for watching.